Suppose in this pivot table, I need to get the total of product 1 and product 2 or the sum of value sales of the first 3 names versus the last 3 names, then what will be the easiest way to do it? Grouping can be one of the options, but pivot table has its own pivot table tools, calculated field and calculated item. These values are in lakhs, which I have converted from this data using calculated field. In this video, I will explain the working of calculated field and calculated item in pivot table. This is also an important video. Please watch carefully. Welcome to ASPC Excel Guides. This pivot table is created from this data dump, and these are called slicer, which we can use to control the pivot table. If you want to know about slicer, please watch the previous video. I have given the link in the description. We have conditional formatting in this pivot table. Let me remove it for now. Let us first understand calculated field. What is calculated field? A calculated field is a field that uses existing fields and applies additional logic to the field. It creates new data from the existing data. A calculated field either performs some calculation on existing fields to create a value that is not directly stored in the data dump, or selects values in the data dump fields based on some customized criteria. Please remember, calculated field will not alter any data in the data dump. I have already one calculated field in this pivot table. Let me remove it. So, this is the actual pivot table. The value field is sales. Let us convert this sales field into lakhs from numbers. Select any cell in the pivot table, then go to Analyze menu in the ribbon. In the Calculations tab, we have Fields, Items and Sets button. Click this button. Calculated field is active, but calculated item is sanded. Click on the Calculated field option. A new window, Insert Calculated field, opens. First text box is Name. We have to type a name for the field. Type a name. Value cells. The next text box is formula. We are going to convert sales value into lakhs. Therefore, we need to divide the sales by 1 lakh. In the fields box, we have all the fields that are actually existing in the source table. Either double click on the sales field, or you can click the insert field button after selecting the sales field. This field will move to the formula text box. Now hit front slash to insert the division operator and type 1 lakh, or you can use 10 and then caret sign and 5. The caret sign works same as power in mathematics. Click add and OK. This is prompting that the data in the next columns will be replaced. I have no issue with this replacement. I will ignore the warning. Now, right click on the pivot table and open the pivot table field list window. We have two fields in the values box. This is our previous field and this is our new field, value sales. Remove the previous field and close the field list window. The data is now converted to lakhs. Let's discuss another scenario. Suppose we need to get the percentage of target versus sales made in this pivot table, but we don't have any target in the source table. So we will create targets in this dump. Insert a column after product column. Name it as target. Let me set the target as 1.5 times more than the unit sold. Then multiply it with sale price. Target is set, but pivot table will not display the target column. Why? Because pivot table is not informed that a new column is inserted. Refresh the pivot table and the target column is visible now. Here it is. Another point to note here is that as the source dump is in table format, so we don't need to reassign the data source from this button. Our goal is to display the percentage of sales with respect to target in this pivot table. Go to Analyze menu. Under Calculations tab, click on the Fields, Items and Sets button. Click on Calculated field. Now name the field. Name it as percent. You can use any name. In the formula text box, enter the formula. To get the achievement percentage, we need to divide the sales made with the target. Now, which sales value to insert in the formula text box? Original sales or the calculated sales? Original sales field, because our target is in actual number format, not in lakhs. Double click on the sales field, not the value sales. Then put the division operator front slash. Double click the target field. But suppose if in some products target is zero, then this formula will give you division error. Okay, let me show you how to overcome this. I will click OK. Now this is division error. We can avoid this error. Let's edit the calculated field again. Open calculated field window. From this drop down, select the percentage field. Our formula is displaying. Type if error after the equal to sign. Opening bracket. Then go to the end of the formula and put a comma and type 0. Close the bracket. If there is any error in the percentage, it will show 0%. Click on OK. Let me arrange this pivot table. This pivot table is now displaying the sales value and the percentage of the target achieved. We have converted this source table into this pivot table report without changing the source data. Now, let's suppose I want to see these 3 employees in a single row and the remaining 3 employees in another row. Here, we need to use calculated item. Please note the difference. Calculated item will insert item, but calculated field will insert a field. But none of these will change the source data. Let's do it. Select any cell in this column. Go to Analyze menu. Under Calculations tab, click on the Fields, Items and Sets button. Now calculated item is active. Click it. A new window opens. Insert calculated item name. Remember, we have our cursor in the name column. Type a name in the formula text box. Say EMP group 1. We will group Davis, Johnson and Jones in group 1. We have 2 text boxes. One is fields and another is items. The items will change as per the fields. It will not work on the numbers or dates. It will only work on text. Select the name field. Double click Davis, then enter plus sign. Double click Johnson and plus sign. Again double click on Jones. We have employee group 1. Similarly, I will create employee group 2. Now, either from this drop down or from this slicer, I will select only employee groups. All the employee sales are now grouped in 2. Slicer is really very good tool. Please try to use it in your reports. I have one video you can watch. I have given the link in the description box. You can also create a new calculated item in the segment section. Let me group government and small business. You can watch for your revision. So, this is how we use calculated field and calculated item in pivot table. Please like and click the subscribe button and click the bell icon to get modern Excel tutorial notifications. Thank you for your interest. See you in next video in another topic.